And now we're sitting here with Academy Award winner Jeremy Irons. Jeremy, I'm sure, and the new film Appaloosa, I'm sure you don't remember, but we met briefly at the opening night of Godspell in London in 1970. Were you the singing and dancing Judas?
I wasn't old enough to have been there.
Oh, okay. It was somebody else then, but you were.
The singing and dancing Judas, yeah.
Right, in Godspell with Julie Covington singing.
David Essex. Yeah, not much has changed.
Well, you're still playing bad guys so well. Do you want to talk a little bit about your character before we get our 3-minute cut off?
Well, no, not really. I mean, he's a guy in this movie in Appaloosa.
What's his name?
Randall Bragg.
Randall Bragg, okay.
Yeah, he's from the East Coast. He's gone out west to make his fortune.
And he's a bad guy.
You think so?
Do you think so?
I don't know. Have you met my mother? No.
No, I haven't.
He's all right. He plays it his way and loses, actually. But
But you do make us see it from his point of view, which I liked.
Good. I think I've never.
He seemed more interesting than that. As the film continued.
Well, I think bad guys are always more interesting. Always felt this. I remember when I spoke to John McTiernan when I saw the cut of Die Hard, and I said, why have you cut so much? He said, because he was too interesting. I said, I know, they are. Bad guys are very interesting.
Klaus von Bülow?
Yeah.
Is that a bad guy? Is that a good guy? It's ambiguous. Yeah. Brad said Revisited, good guy, bad guy, again.
Good guy, bad guy. I mean, who can tell?
Right. Well, you scared me to death when you did Judas and Godspell in 1970. And it's just as scary and got it all going on here, the bad guy mojo in Appaloosa. Thank you so much, Jeremy Irons. Yes, very nice.